G'day guys, Cam here from thefishroom.co.nz, and today we're going to go through my packaging procedure of what I do when I'm sending live fish around the country. So I really hope this is helpful for you guys. I know there's been a few people recently on some of the Facebook forums asking how do you send fish, so hopefully this little guide will help everybody out. So let's do this. So as simple as it is, we need rubber bands, heat pack, plastic bags, some sticky tape, you're going to need a net, a poly box, and I use an air pump, which I don't have because it's running at the moment, so we'll go out there and have a look at it later. So it's pretty easy with what we need. Alright, let's do this. Okay, so I'm not actually doing this with fish because I think that'd be kind of mean and stressful for them to bag them up and not actually doing it with it, so we'll just do it with plain water. So first of all, we need our bag. I hook the edges around. Water, I normally take two of these scoops from an aquarium. Two from my tap. And that there is the water that we're going to be using to send fish in. Alright, then we get our handy dandy scoop. Scoop our fish out. Into our bag. Alright, so we've got our bag of water. We've got a rubber band. But this is when our air pumps come in. So we stick our air lines. In this case, lines. Normally just the air line. Into our bag, like so. Give it a wee twist at the top so it doesn't escape. And we just let the air line fill up the bag. This will take a little while because this air pump is really, really small and slow because it doesn't need to do much, it's only a couple of tanks. But your bigger air pumps normally go a lot quicker than this. You see it's filling it up. Fill. I tend to avoid blowing into the bags. I think just using straight air from an air pump is a better option than going into a bag. If I had some O2 on a bottle thing and a trigger, that would be my by far preferred option, but I do not have one of them, so I use my airline. So as we can see, we're filling up now, so I'm going to give it another twist, keep it secure, rip out my lines, holding that same spot, twist some more. And now we've got a full bag of air with our fish. We get our rubber band. We get it over. And that's when we just close up our bag. I'm sure plenty of you will have tied off fish bags before. It's not the hardest thing to do in the world. And now, in theory, we have our bag with our fish swimming through here, ready to be sent. So let's go to the next stage. Okay, so now it's sellotape time. Because I don't use rounded edge bags, so I use sellotape. It's pretty simple. Get a hoon of tape. Tape it on one edge and bring it in. Then I flip it around. I do the same thing. So this is also making better structure on the bag, but it's also sort of making it a bit more tighter. So I give another wee twist now. Get another rubber band. Just underneath the first one. Drop it there. And keeping it in place and tight up. I'm back. Now, I get a second fish bag. Open it up again. Get my first one. Give it the mouthing. All right, so. Flip her in, and didn't quite go in straight. I'm going to go in far straighter. And I sit like so, inside it. And I take, get this one, spin it around right at the point of the top of the other bag. Another rubber band. and tighten it up. Like so. So now we've got double bags, we've got rounded corners so the fish can't get stuck. Double bag, so if they potentially pierce the inside bag, it's not going to pierce the outside bag, and we're good to go. So this is the bag of water that the fish are traveling in, and so they are good to go, ready to rock. Next stage. Okay, so next step is the heat pack. I'm not using a brand new one because I don't have one, but even if I did have one, I wouldn't be using a new one because I'm not actually sending any fish. But you get your packet, you rip it open, comes out like this, almost a little bit flatter than this, and you just give it a quick shake, loosen everything up, give it a little shake, and then I normally just leave it aside for a little bit. It takes a couple minutes for it to activate. When I sort of feel that it's been a little warm, that's when I chuck it into the poly box. But that's the next step. You can do that at any point on the process, earlier the better, but normally once I've bagged it up, that's what we do now. Okay, so now we put our bag of fish into our poly box. You try and find a poly box that is suitable for the size. This box should be able to handle four bags, not one. Try and, if you only see one bag, find a poly box of the right size. Otherwise, pack it out with scrunched up newspaper around it, so you don't want the bag moving around. Try and keep your bag relatively upright. I put them on a bit of an angle, like so. If you have them like this, water potentially has a chance of squashing out, especially if you're using rubber bands over like bands. So I try and have them upright as possible, but it also depends on the type of fish that I am sending. So once we have, we'll just imagine we've got four boxes, bags in here, then we load it up with a bit of newspaper. You can imagine how that would work. The rest will be sitting up, and then from there we can use our poly bin. We get our heat pack, and you can either tape it to here, or you can put it on top of the newspaper, between a couple of pieces of paper, depends on what you're doing. Most of the wholesalers tape their heat packs onto the bin. I am naturally assuming that is because if your bags leak and you've got newspaper, the water potentially could come up and wet the newspaper and wet your heat pack a lot easier than what it will if it's on there. So there we go, we've got our bags in, we've got our heat pack going. So now we close her up. So it's closed, we've got our heat pack in there, we've got our fish in there, we've got a nice solid poly box, and we've got some paper in there. Now we've got to tape up around the edges. So just with our tape. You don't want to go too heavy on the tape because you still want a little bit of oxygen to be able to get through, because that's how your heat pack works. So that will be absolutely fine. It ain't coming off. It's solid. We're good to go. Now you get labeling. Alright, so we've made up our labels. Stick him on. Want to put as much information as we can, who it's going to, where it's going to, their suburb, their phone number, where it's come from with a phone number. We also want to write on it, live fish, tropical fish, keep warm, do not chill. If you see any other previously addressed stickers, cross them out. If you have any urgent stickers like these or overnight stickers, put them on. And if you do not have any, then you take them to your courier, see, please, can you put one on for me? So you get that going. We then stick our courier ticket on it. And we put it on the top right-hand side beside that. So that is our courier ticket from where we're going. There is one last step that we need to finish. Bear with me. We get our Vividi pen. Arrows going up. Arrows going up. Top. Arrows going up. We do this all, there goes the tape, all the way around. So we now have a box of fish ready to go to our couriers. So there it is, nice and simple. One poly box with a heat pack, with a bag of fish, ready to go to the new owner. Couriers charge by weight and dimensions here in New Zealand, I don't know about around the world. So like I said, if you've only got one bag, there's no point in putting them in. a box that does four because you'll get charged through the dimensions. And I only use two of those cups of water, which is the equivalent of 2 liters, so about 2 kilos of water. So we're trying to keep the weight as light as possible as well. I try to take my poly boxes down to the courier as late as possible. I tend to do that at around about 4:30, quarter to 5, so the fish are in transit for as least time as possible. And then also, if you can contact the person that you're sending the fish to, my advice is to get them to get courier pickup, depot pickup. So if you do, just write on your box, depot pickup, and then they can pick it up in the morning, so it's even less time the fish in transit. If you leave here sort of for 4 o'clock-ish and they get picked up at 8 o'clock, you're only looking at what, 16 hours in transit? That's not too bad at all. Okay, so just a few other little tips and tricks before you go and send it. If you know you're going to send some fish away, what I tend to do is 2 days before do a decent sized water change, getting as much of the nitrates and stuff like that out of the water as possible to keep the water as clean as possible for your fish. And if I know I'm sending fish, I tend to not feed them for a couple of days prior as well, so they're completely evacuated all the bowels and stuff like that, so your water is as clean and as pristine as possible before it actually goes in the bag ready to go on the journey, because you never know, something might happen. It might be in transit for 2 or 3 days or something stupid like that. So the better you can keep the water on the way in, the better it's going to be on the way out for the new owner. So that's just a little bit of an extra tip that I like to do if I know that I'm sending fish. I know that's not always possible, but if that's what you can do, you're in a far better chance of getting those fish alive to your customer or your whoever you sold your fish to, your mate's house or what have you. So I hope that you found this really informative, and any sort of demons that you might have had in your mind about sending fish has disappeared. It is truly a very simple process. As long as you've got all the equipment you need at the time, make sure your water's clean before you send it. Get everything ready to go, have a good plan in mind, get it all done, and away you go. It's not that hard. A little bit time consuming, yes, but it's not actually that hard. And then you can get your fish out to where you need it to go. So that's all I've got for you today, guys. I really hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you can take this information on board and start sending some fish around the countryside. Hobbyists helping hobbyists is the way this hobby is going to grow, so hopefully it helps everybody. If you've liked it and subscribed, give it a like. If you've got any questions on it, I know there's probably lots of questions that you can ask within this video, so if you've got any questions, please bang them down below. We answer every question that we get, so if you need any help, always here. All right, team, I'm out of here. Have a good one. Happy fish giving, and catch you later. You're relentless, leaving nothing but ashes, like a fire burning out of control. So save yourself.